Can't be moved. you walk tall and brave. I'll be there for you, you'll be there for me. In the dark, through the wet and the rain.
So one of the most fun parts about being an animator on this project is every now and then I would just get a really awesome model from Sync, and I'd think to myself, how can I push this and how can I have fun with this? And I remember this raft for the character when we first got it. I think everybody was imagining it would be this static raft. And I remember early on we were trying to come up with a way to transition between when you were on the river and when you were on land. And we needed some kind of visual to cover that up. And so I kind of made this docking animation, and I was like, trying to figure out, is there going to be a rope on every dock that you tie to the raft? And then I just rigged up the raft so that the tire could come off and you could throw the tire over the dock. And as I did it, I thought to myself, oh no, Sammy's going to kill me. I totally messed up his model to do this and probably stretching it. And he was like, he liked it. And that was kind of the beginning of the raft becoming a bigger and bigger thing.
You know, I certainly didn't think in modeling or in the concept phase of creating that raft that it would be so modular or dynamic, and it was really cool to see Gwen work her magic through rigging and animation to make that thing come to life. You know, the way it would rock, the way the planks would come off, the way the tire was used. It's amazing for how few back faces were put into that model.
Yeah.
Now.
You keep in mind, I took the initial rafts and I made it have damaged dates and I made it so that things could fly off and stuff. And then after the fact, we decided that we needed to be able to upgrade the raft. We needed to be able to bolt all these other things onto the raft. And you had this temporary shelter that was always there, and that had to...
Well, that was such a challenge, too, of trying to fit all that stuff into, like, what amounts to a few pixels on screen.
Yeah, Sync crushed it with that stuff. Animating the raft is probably the most fun I've had across this game, because between like the marina animations, the hit reacts, and the stuff flying off the raft.
Definitely above and beyond what I thought we were going to end up with.
I think it turned out pretty well, and it was a really fun collaboration with me and Sync. I really enjoyed doing that.
Yeah, so one of the things early on, you know, we're just starting the project, we were looking for mood and inspiration, and that meant, you know, looking at books and films and whatnot. And one thing that we started was, I think, a Spotify playlist, and we were just picking out different musicians and whatnot. And there was a guy, William Elliott Whitmore, that I really liked. He had an album called Field Songs, and it was just this very gravelly kind of country folk acoustic guitar stuff. And I started playing this for Sync and the folks in the studio. And, you know, we started building up this playlist, and Sync at one point kind of interrupted and was like, you know, I know a guy who does this kind of stuff. And that, I think, sparked us working with Chuck.
I think hearing that playlist initially, I think it was immediately apparent that was the direction we wanted to go, at least for me. I don't remember how far along we were and what reference point we were at when we decided to go for the Southern Wilds thematically.
I think tonally. It was pretty early. I think we sort of zeroed in on that pretty quickly. Like, it was sort of Survive, River, and then we kind of zeroed in on the South.
Yeah. I think going into this, we knew audio was going to play a huge role, especially having come from Irrational and knowing how much that can do for you.
Yeah, I mean, I do remember some of our early conversations with Chuck about it, and, you know, I feel like super fortunate that we were able to work with him. And I know, Sync, you had quite a lot of history.
Yeah, so Chuck Reagan is a longtime friend of mine, met in college, played in bands together, toured together. And the evolution of his career led him to be producing music that, you know, fit the bill, like, to a T, what we were looking for. And it was just a natural, obvious collaboration to kick off. Couldn't have worked out better.
Yeah, so one of the things early on, you know, we're just starting the project, we were looking for mood and inspiration, and that meant, you know, looking at books and films and whatnot. And one thing